We have almost completed the part 2, determination of rate controlling step and estimation of overall rate of reaction, and that is to be done with the help of model contactor. Gas liquid we discussed in great detail, and then all those model contactors can be used for liquid-liquid system. As far as solid liquid or solid gas is concerned, I very, very briefly described what would be a typical model contactor. But today I will show you the solid liquid and solid gas systems are relatively very easy, mainly because when we know particle size distribution, we already know the interfacial area. So one requirement of model contactor, that is the interfacial area, should be known. That gets already defined when we select any set of particles. Now the second requirement is we should be able to vary. There should be a provision to change the mass transfer coefficient. And here there are simple possibilities. Imagine this first. This is a pipeline in which we put screens on two sides and take some differential volume, maybe 10 millimeters, 20 millimeters of that order. And in that space, in that differential volume, we put our solid particles. Suppose this is 20 mm and our particles are 3 mm and the diameter of the pipe is say 30 millimeters, then we put particles with screens on both the sides. And the area occupied by the screen metal is less than 5%. So the flow area is more or less equal to cross-sectional area, and the screens are used only for retaining particles from both the sides. Have you understood? Just the design of the equipment. It is a pipeline of which certain volume is selected as a reactor. When we select certain volume, then we bound it at the inlet and outlet by a screen. Screen has a good voidage, more than 90%, more than 95%. And within the space of these two screens, the solid phase is accommodated. The solid particles are kept in that region. So this becomes the reactor. This becomes the model contactor. As I told you already, it's, whenever particle size distribution or particle sizes are known, we know the area exposed by the particles or interfacial area is known. Right? And the second requirement, that the mass transfer coefficient between solid and liquid, that should be varied, that is done with the help of the liquid or gas flow rate. Suppose superficial velocity is 1 cm/s, we can vary it to 2, 3, 5, 10, 20 centimeter per second, and then we are able to get the inlet concentration is known, outlet concentration is noted with respect to time, and we can calculate the rate. So when the rate is known, again, the overall stepwise procedure is same. First of all, we try to find out how much time is required for 50% conversion. Is it hours? Is it minutes? Is it several seconds? It is few seconds. On the basis of that, we take a note that it may be instantaneous, it may be fast, it may be very slow, all right? And then if it is very slow, then we try to bring it to regime 2. If it is between 2 and 3, either we bring it to 2 or bring it to 3. If it is between 3 and 4, we bring it to 3. And how to do that? By playing with S star and B naught and KL and KMN, that is utilizing the Arrhenius constant and the activation energy, making use of that and changing the rate constant, we can bring all possible reactions to regime 1 or regime 3, where kinetic parameters M, N, and K, M, N are there. So this I have explained, correct? And you have understood? Yes? Yeah. So that was using model contactor. Now here there is nothing different. Now this is the simplest model contactor which we can use. And in this model contactor, now mass transfer coefficient can be varied. And if it is slow, then it will be mass transfer coefficient. Right now we wish to have it in 1. So what is that we can do? Here, keep on increasing flow rate till it becomes independent of flow rate, so it becomes kinetically controlled. All right. Then find the rate with respect to the liquid phase concentration, the solid phase concentration at a given temperature. Make similar measurements with different particle size distribution, where interfacial area is different, and with the help of this information, you can get specific rate of absorption. If it is in the first regime, then ln rate versus ln A star, if you plot, then you will get M. Similarly, you can get N. The specific rate at a given A star and B naught will give value of Kmn, right? The solid loading is known to us. The particles that we place in this volume, that particle weight, particle density is known. So the fraction of volume in which reaction is occurring, that is also known. And interfacial area of solid phase, we note down in terms of always meter square per meter cube. That is one reactor. The another reactor is a Carberry reactor. Are you able to see this Carberry reactor? Maybe that picture was better, or the other one. We deleted, no? Anyway, let me try to explain, otherwise you can come closer. Imagine this to be an impeller. This is a shaft, and this is a straight blade turbine. Straight blade turbine having 4 blades, but the blades are in such a way that each blade is a basket, where there is a screen on the front side and screen on the back side. Are you able to get it? I will explain again. You know straight blade turbine. So for a straight blade turbine, try to have only bracket like this, and the put screen on the front side as well as back side. And in the space in between the two screens, put particles inside. It is exactly like this. But here in this case, mass transfer coefficient is varied by changing the flow rate. Here, what could be done? RPM, very good. So we keep on changing the speed. When it becomes independent of speed, it is kinetically controlled, we get the rate constants. If it is instantaneous reaction and try to bring it to third regime, then we know how to play with root M and phi A so that B naught is sufficiently large. We can increase B naught. We can increase KL. So increasing, how we can increase KL? By RP, increase KL. B naught anyway is in our control, the liquid phase concentration. So B naught by Z star should be much higher than the root M. And root M, again we can manipulate. Reducing temperature will reduce Kmn, right? Increasing KL in the denominator will reduce M. So all these possibilities we use and try to bring it in third regime. Over the years, based on this part two, we have been able to formulate about 40 questions, which have been circulated to you. Correct? Looks familiar? Has it been sent to you? Right? And let me see. I'm going to solve two problems here. Forty-four are there. Okay? Two I'm solving randomly. And you solve 42. And let me openly declare that one of these will appear in the examination. There was a solution book which I never wanted that you should get it. Therefore, I searched a lot. I asked large number of past students. Nobody is having, so I'm a very happy person. And this is the set of books which I solved all the 44 problems when I was in BKMINJ. Right? So one who solve, not one who, so try to solve all of them. Let us solve two of them, based on the whatever theory we have learnt up till now. Can you open problem number one? Calculate specific rate of absorption of gas A at atmospheric pressure in a medium containing reacting species B at 30 degrees centigrade. When absorption of A is accompanied by relatively very fast reaction. Reaction is A plus B giving products. The reaction is first order in A and B. So many things are given. Second order rate constant is also given. Solubility of A in the solvent containing species B is 4 into 10 raised to minus 2 gram mole per liter per atmosphere. Concentration of B is given 1 gram mole per liter. Diffusivities of A and B are given. Physical mass transfer coefficient, that is KL, is 0.02 centimeter per second. If you make any assumptions, justify them. Discuss in detail the effect of raising the temperature from 30 degrees to 70 degrees on the specific rate of absorption of A. Make suitable assumptions, etc. The solvent has properties similar to water. You have the problem?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So let us try to solve. The rest is good. Can you tell me the approach? M is given, N is given. Value of KL is given. since it is 1, 1, K2 is equal to 4 into 10 raised to 4. So all the information is given. It seems that experiments were performed using some model contactor. Using the methodology which I taught you, M is calculated, N is calculated, the rate constant is known. There is a case where for a certain B naught and A star, the specific rate of absorption, that is the objective, calculate. Kilomoles per meter square per second. Diffusivity of A, diffusivity of B are given, and true mass transfer coefficient is also given. So how to begin? Just let us have a clue. We want a specific rate of absorption. Before that, what is that we should know? Regime of operation. And how to get that? So calculate. Maybe we can calculate first of all. K2 into A star into B naught. What is this value? Array, somebody should calculate very quickly. K2 is given A star into B naught. Pressure, I think it is given. Thank you. That's that. Since m is 1, n is 1, s star raised to m minus 1, that is 1, b naught raised to n is b naught raised to 1, mn becomes k2, 2 upon m plus 1, since m is 1, 2 upon 2 is 1, and diffusivity. Tell me the value of this. Diffusivity of A is given, k2 is given, b naught is given. How much? Thirty-eight. And finally, 4. One plus V naught by Z star starting, of course, given is A plus B is equal to products. How much is this value? Is equal to 9.9.3. Now, if you refer to our big table which we had prepared for regime 1 and regime 2, the reaction does not happen in the film. And therefore, root m has to be much less than 1. Correct, no? Now, here root m is greater than, is 38. Is greater than, much greater than 5. Anyway, it is 38. This means that it is not very slow. It is not slow. And anyway, in the problem also, it is indicated that it is relatively fast reaction. So, root m is 38.7. But 1 plus B naught by Z star into dB by dA is 9.33. So what does it mean? Where are we? For third regime, what is the condition required? For R3, regime 3, root m has to be much less than, did I use phi a? and regime 4 root m has to be greater than phi. Have you written this any time?
Yes.
Yeah. So the value of 9.33 is ultimate enhancement factor. Root m is here 38.7. So which condition is satisfied? Regime 4. Right. So definitely phi a is less than root m, or root m is greater than phi a. But whenever we say that much less or much greater, it has to be 10 times. I must have said this. Yeah. Between KL A to be compared with epsilon L into K2 A star into B naught, when anything is said to be negligible as compared to other, it has to be at least 10 times more. So is it 10 times different?
No.
No. Then what is the conclusion? Between 3 and 4. And between 3 and 4, the enhancement factor is phi is equal to root m phi a minus phi upon phi a minus 1 raised to n by 2, but n in our case is 1. So phi is on both the sides, so we will have to calculate. So we'll have to do by trial and error, LSS, RHS. Suppose we take phi to be 15, then what is right hand side? Root m is 38.7. You got that? Very good, very good. Array, let everybody understand.
The phi value is 15, you get the right hand side to be the square root of negative 1. It is not possible.
Yeah. Good, good, good. But one who got the value, how explained to everybody? Okay. So LHS is 8.89. RHS has to be 8.89. So you calculated? Let us write 38.7 into bracket 9.33 minus 8.89 divided by 9.33 minus 1 raised to half is equal to 8.89. So actual enhancement factor is 8.89, all right? And therefore, overall rate of absorption, here both absorption and chemical reaction is taken. Therefore, either we say that it is overall rate of absorption or we say overall rate of reaction, combination of mass transfer and chemical reaction. So what is the rate? Specific rate Ra is equal to phi times KL into A star. Up till now, we are familiar in writing RAA is equal to phi into KLA into S star. This we have been doing. But now the answer required is specific rate, that is per meter square. So what is phi is 8.89. KL value given is 2 into 2 into minus 4. And S star is 4 into 10 raised to minus 2. So what is the overall answer? 7.5. And it is specific rate, that is kilomoles. Per meter square second. If it is overall rate or volumetric rate, then it should have been per meter cube second, right? But then in that case, we would need interfacial area. So this was part one, and part two says, if the temperature is raised to 70 degrees, what will be the effect of raising the temperature from 30 degrees to 70 degrees on the specific rate of absorption? Suitable assumptions can be made. The solvent has properties akin to water. Now we need KMN, that is value of K2 at 30 degrees is given. So assumption to be made is activation energy. Is say minus 80,000 kilojoules per kilomole. Anything else? Degrees Kelvin. So using activation energy, how do we calculate rate constant at that temperature? 70 degrees? Yeah. K2 at 70 degrees. Divided by K2 at 30 degrees is equal to what? E raised to minus 1/RT, that is 30 degrees, upon e raised to minus e upon RT. So convert this into absolute temperature and tell me the ratio. What is the value of R? I'm sure you know the value. 0.02. Yeah. Ratio is how much? 0.025. 40.58. So you take reciprocal of your value. You got your value. Now who got 40? Take reciprocal of that. Is that your value? Yeah. So where is a mistake? Very good. The rate constant at higher temperature has to be, and the ratio has to be greater than 40.5. And therefore, K2 at 70 degrees is equal to 40.5 times K2 at 30 degrees, which is equal to 1.10^6. Now what will be the value of root m? New value of root m. What is changed as compared to earlier root m? K2, which is square root. Earlier was some 38.7. Now K2 is enhanced by a factor of 40. So root m will be now. You can do that all over again.
246.3.
How much?
246.3.
Very good. And phi A, how much was phi A? Nine point three three. Listen to me. Phi A, which is 1 plus B naught by Z star dB by dA, will B naught vary with respect to temperature concentration of liquid phase reactant, which was given to be 1 kilomole per meter cube. So that is not going to change. divided by Z, is Z going to change? A plus B going to products, that is not going to change. What will happen to A star? It will change. A star will change. And normally, the solubility of gases in liquids, it decreases with rise in temperature. And diffusivity also changes. Now, we have been permitted to make suitable assumptions. Right. We can always make a big assumption, that is, we assume that the answer is 1 into 10 raised to minus 7 kilomole per meter square second. Then the problem will be, give suitable reasons. Correct? Right. So whenever dB is changing and dA is changing, we can make an assumption both are changing by same factor, by rise in temperature. That is possible. Correct, no? Otherwise, we need activation energy for diffusivity of A and diffusivity of B, and we write similar correction factor for diffusivities. But whenever there is ratio, the ratio as far as diffusivity is concerned and solubility also is concerned, the ratio remains constant with respect to temperature. Now, the only problem is with A star. I can give you the activation energy for A star, where at a higher temperature, there is reduction in A star. So let me give activation energy for solubility that we should not assume constant. So instead of 80,000, it is 5,000. Only difference is this is plus. So rate constant increased, the saturation concentration will decrease. So A star, I need not write now. You are able to do that. How much is this value? So new A star, therefore, A star at 70 degrees is 0.79 times A star at 30 degrees. This is equal to 0.79. How much is this value? What is the answer? So root m we got, the phi a at 30 degrees was known, phi a at 70 degrees. Is equal to again 1 plus V naught by nu ZS, nu A star, and we write the assumption that dB by dA remains 1. How much is this value?
11.5.
Now compare root m and phi a.
Sir, root m is roughly 21 times greater than phi a.
Yeah. So that is the answer, that now we can say that root m is much greater than phi a. And we are in regime
4.
Just now we wrote those conditions. So we are in the regime. This concludes that we are in the regime 4. And therefore, what is the specific rate of absorption? RA KL is 2 into 10 raised to minus 4. A star is, there is a new A star, 0.0316. And 1 plus that enhancement factor, ultimate enhancement factor, is 11.5. Is equal to? How much? Specific rate. Kilomole per meter square second. This part 2, the title is Determination of Rate Controlling Step and Estimation of Overall Rate of Reaction Using Model Contactor. As far as this example was concerned, the experiments were performed. Value of m was found out to be equal to 1, n was found out to be equal to 1. At 30 degrees, value of K2 was also found out. The saturation concentration A star, that was measured. B naught, concentration in liquid phase, was taken, right? And the answer is how to estimate overall rate of reaction. In the first case that we took, it was between 3 and 4. So the rate controlling step is the overall reaction falls between regime 3 and 4. And therefore, overall rate between regimes 3 and 4 we calculated. Understood? Then the temperature was raised to 70 degrees. The experiments were already done. with the help of activation energies, we took the appropriate values of K2 and A star, and then found out that the rate controlling step is regime 4. And therefore, overall rate of reaction specific, the specific rate of reaction is 7.26 into 10 raised to minus 5. Have you understood now the basis for this, this part 2? There are 44 problems. I wish to solve one more. Is it a good idea?
Yes.
Raise your hands. No. I'll solve one more. You'll get a lot of practice. There are in between some examples where speed is varied, but there is no effect. Since we want that kinetics should come out of the problem, then this particular statement is made. Then how the rate depends upon A, rate depends upon B. Rate does not depend upon B. What are the possibilities? The rate doesn't depend upon B. How many possibilities are there? If anybody gives answers in next 10 seconds, I'll give 50 rupees. Array, this class still I'm not able to give any prize. I'm asking difficult questions. It is independent of B naught. Concentration of B, that is one answer. Array, in that big table, how many observations we made? Correct, na?
Yes.
So you took more than 10 seconds. We wrote those rates, we made a big table. Is it there in your notebook?
Yes.
In regime 2, it is independent of B naught. In regime 4, it is independent of A star. Correct? Another possibility is, which we should not rule out, is order with respect to B is 0. But it should be consistent with other observations. Right?